Here's what's involved building a bellows and bag with the David Daye instructions. Draw a design onto the piece of shelf wood, ordinary poplar or pine, some other inexpensive wood. Any kind of saw can cut the straight sections, hand saw or a jigsaw like this, or a bandsaw in a shop. Then a simple file can round the edges, or perhaps a belt sander if you have one of those. You need a couple hole saws to put holes for air intake and output in the two wooden paddles. Varnish, a simple towel will do well enough for that. For the leather for the bellows, you cut a simple shape, which is shown in the booklet, and it's all glued together with leather glue, easily obtained. You can see fitting it onto the bellows after the glue has become tacky. For the budget vinyl bag, the more inexpensive method, fabric can be obtained at local fabric stores, and then it's cut and then bonded with a marine bedding compound, a specific type that's very strong. Put it on the seam and then just set something flat on it to clamp. A leather bag is a little more expensive and a little bit more trouble to make if you should choose this way, but it is a lifetime investment if you want to do that. Cut it for pattern, and then there's some protective strips that are made. You can see the curve has been notched so it will go around, and it's been glued up, and we're now pushing the glue down on. And again, with the bag glued, clamped, and now we put the protective covers over the joint. Sockets for the pipe are made of ordinary plumber's pipe, and a little file, you can put a groove around it so that it's easy to tie the bag into a secure spot. And here's tying the bag. You'll use ordinary razor blade or maybe a knife to cut a little hole in a star shape into where the stock is going to be inserted. And wrap some heavy twine around an object to put between your feet, pull it tight. With the stock in the bag, you can wrap that around snugly. It'll make a nice airtight joint, as you can see when it's done, at each end of the bag. For padding for the bellows, a little bit of leather, if you wish, or some fabric, whatever you choose, and a piece of foam from any kind of foam for protection, and glue it up and you've got an arm pad. The valves and connectors are made from ordinary plumbing and piping material. A little piece of leather valve for flap for each of the two valves. And that's just about all there is. And for the belt, you can get belts at any fashion store or clothing store. And everything screws on with screws and screwdriver. No complicated equipment needed to assemble it. And we'll put the pieces together. There's the socket or stock for the air intake or blowpipe. There's the stock for the chanter melody pipe. And there's our valve made with the plumbing pipe and the leather on the end. Plug it into the side where the air intake goes. Now we'll get the bellows with the belts on it, and you just fasten that around your waist. Plug the air hose, air supply hose in, buckle it up. And now you take a chanter. Any chanter will do. This is my penny chanter you could build or buy. That's 20 years old. I'm still playing it.